So today we will learn about chi-square distribution, its definition and the properties. So a continuous random variable chi-square with a PDF f of chi-square is equal to 1 by 2 the whole raised to n by 2 divided by gamma n by 2 multiplied by e raised to minus chi-square by 2 into multiplied by chi-square raised to n by 2 minus 1, where the value of chi-square lies between 0 and infinity and is equal to 0 elsewhere, is said to follow a chi-square distribution with the degrees of freedom n. So this was the definition of a chi-square variable. Now the chi-square variable is a continuous variable. Okay, so that is the PDF is also given over here. Now let's move on to the properties of a chi-square distribution. First, we will have a look at the mean of chi-square distribution. Okay, so as you all know, we know how to find out the mean of a certain variable if it is given. How did we find out the mean? By using expectation. So here also we are using expectation of chi-square, which is equal to, since chi-square is a continuous variable and the range is from 0 to infinity, we write it as integral 0 to infinity chi-square into f of chi-square d chi-square. Okay, this is how we write, which is equal to integral 0 to infinity chi-square. What is the density function of chi-square? That is, we have already learned, 1 by 2 the whole raised to n by 2 divided by gamma n by 2 multiplied by e raised to minus chi-square by 2 into chi-square the whole raised to n by 2 minus 1 d chi-square. Okay, so that was the density function, which is equal to, I'm going to take outside all the constants. So what are the constants over here? 1 by 2 raised to n by 2 divided by gamma n by 2 integral 0 to infinity chi-square. There are two chi-squares over here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to club that 2 chi square in such a way that chi square the whole raised to, you have 1 chi square over here and then you have chi square n by 2 minus 1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write this as n by 2 from here plus 1, okay, minus 1. This is how I'm going to rearrange chi-square. Then the remaining is e raised to minus chi-square by 2 d chi-square. Okay, so if you closely observe this part, that is from only this part, not the constants, what is this? This is somewhat similar to your gamma function, right? That is chi square raised to, now consider this as your p minus 1 e raised to minus m into that particular variable, right? So that is how you connect this with your gamma function, if you remember. Then how can you rewrite that? Okay, I'm going to rewrite it as 1 by 2 the whole raised to, the constants I'm going to write as it is, 1 by 2 the whole raised to gamma n, 1 by 2 the whole raised to n by 2 divided by gamma n by 2. Then what about the next term? It was a gamma function, so multiplied by, now what is your gamma function? I hope you remember that. What is it? Gamma p. Now in this case your p is what? N by 2 plus 1. This is your p, right? So in a gamma function you have the final answer as what? Gamma p divided by m raised to p. So in this case it is gamma n by 2 plus 1 divided by m raised to p. Now what is your m over here? Your m is 1 by 2, right? This is your variable chi square. Instead of x, it is chi square over here, and your m is 1 by 2. So m raised to p, that is 1 by 2 raised to p. What is your p again? N by 2 plus 1. Now, which is equal to, now you have lots of terms over here, so that it gets cancelled. So here, the numerator over here, that is 1 by 2 raised to n by 2, and 1 by 2 raised to n by 2 gets cancelled over here. Remaining, you have a 1 by 2 here, then you have a gamma n plus 1 by 2, and you have a gamma n by 2 over here, right? So, let's see how we get the final answer as. So this is equal to, if I cancel these terms, what I get is gamma n by 2 plus 1 divided by gamma n by 2 multiplied by, you have a 1 by 2 over here, so that goes to the numerator, it becomes 2. Now this is equal to 2 into, now this will become, what will this become? What is gamma p? Yeah, so applying that that rule over here, that is gamma p is equal to what? P minus 1 into gamma p minus 1. So applying that, what you get is n by 2 into gamma n by 2, the whole divided by gamma n by 2, okay, which is equal to, this gets cancelled, and your final answer is n. So your mean over here is n. Next we will move on to the variance, that is variance of chi square. Now what is variance of chi square? Variance of chi square is nothing but expectation of chi square minus expectation of chi square the whole square, right? Expectation of chi square minus expectation of chi square the whole square. Now this part, that is the second part, we already know, so you don't have to worry about that. You just have to look at the first term, which is equal to integral 0 to infinity chi square 1 by 2, sorry, it is chi square 1 by 2 gamma n by 2 . So you multiply this by, now you can write the density function, that is chi square the whole raised to n by 2 minus 1 e raised to minus chi square by 2 d chi square. Okay, now this is equal to, I'm really sorry, here you have a n by 2 over here. Take the constants outside, that is 1 by 2 raised to n by 2 divided by gamma n by 2, then integral 0 to infinity, you have a chi square here and a chi square raised to n by 2 minus 1 here. I'm going to club this term in such a way that I get chi square raised to n by 2 plus 2, n by 2 plus 2 minus 1, okay, into e raised to minus chi square by 2 d chi square. Now if you closely observe, this is again in the form of what? A gamma function. So how will you write that here? Here your p is n by 2 plus 2 and your m is 1 by 2, so you can write this as, this is equal to 1 by 2 raised to n by 2, which is your constant, divided by gamma n by 2, then multiplied by, you just write the gamma function as what? Your p is n by 2 plus 2 divided by m raised to p. So what is your m over here? It is 1 by 2 raised to p is n by 2 plus 2, which is equal to this and this get cancelled. You get a 4 over here in the numerator, and then you have what? N by 2 plus 1 into n by 2 gamma n by 2. I just expanded this term, that is gamma n by 2 plus 2, divided by, you have a gamma n by 2 over here, which is equal to, the final answer is n into n plus 2, which is equal to n square plus 2n. So this is just your first term. We have to actually find out variance of chi square, which is equal to expectation of chi square square minus expectation of chi square the whole square, right? So this is equal to, what is expectation of chi square square? That is what we have found out just right now. That is n square plus 2n minus, what is the expectation of chi square? The mean, that is n, the whole square means n square, which is equal to this and this get cancelled. Finally, you get the answer as 2n. So this is your variance of chi square. Okay. Next, we will move on to the MGF. Now, in order to find out MGF, you know that the formula for MGF is what? Mt chi square is equal to expectation of e raised to t chi square, which is equal to integral 0 to infinity e raised to t chi square f of chi square d chi square. Okay, so this is equal to take your what constants outside, 1 by 2 raised to n by 2 divided by gamma n by 2, integral 0 to infinity, then you get e raised to t chi square e raised to minus chi square by 2, and you have chi square raised to n by 2 minus 1 d chi square. Now this is equal to 1 by 2 whole raised to n by 2 divided by gamma n by 2, integral 0 to infinity. Now you club this e raised to terms together so that you get e raised to minus chi square by 2. This is the thing that I have taken outside, so inside the bracket I get 1 minus 2t chi square raised to n by 2 minus 1 d chi square. Now this is again in the form of a gamma function where your p is n by 2 and your m is 1 minus 2t divided by 2. Okay, so here this is of the form of a gamma function. Okay, I hope you remember all this. We have studied in the last semester where your m is equal to 1 minus 2t divided by 2 and your p is equal to what? N by 2. Okay. So these two things just keep in mind, and then we have mt chi square, or the MGF of chi square is equal to half raised to n by 2 divided by gamma n by 2 multiplied by, what is it, gamma p, instead of p it is gamma n by 2 divided by 2. और माइनस टू टी बाई टू द होल रेज टू एम रेज टू पी इट इज सो होल रेज टू एन बाई टू दिस इज इक्वल टू ओके यू जस्ट हैव टू कैंसल अ लॉट ऑफ टर्म्स एंड फाइनली यू विल गेट वन माइनस टू टी द होल रेज टू माइनस एन बाई टू नाउ दिस इज द एम जी एफ ऑफ अ काई स्क्वायर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. Thank you.